हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी आर स्टडिंग अबाउट द रिप्रोडक्शन इन प्लांट्स। यस स्टूडेंट्स, द सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन प्लांट्स बाय टेकिंग द स्टडी ऑफ अ टाइपिकल बाइसेक्सुअल फ्लावर इन प्लांट्स। नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिफाइन द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ अ ओव्यूल। यस स्टूडेंट्स, the structure of a ovule, structure of an ovule. Students, if you are going to discuss about the structure of ovule, then ovule is the female reproductive part and it is encloses inside the ovary sac. As you all of you introduced in the previous lecture, this is the hilus from where the integument part is arises, and this is the micropyle region, and the innermost region is the endosperm, in which our ovule is enclosed. The ovules containing sebum cell, among which the three upper cells are having haploid number of chromosomes, and they are called the synergized cells, whereas the basal three cells are also haploid and these are called antipodal cells. In the center of the ovules, a secondary nucleus having two haploid chromosomes are present. This haploid sets of chromosomes fuse to form a zygotic structure. That's why this is called the secondary nucleus or secondary nucleus. These are the synergized cells, and these are the basal cells that are called antipodal cells that located at the opposite pole, antipodal cells. This is the vascular part of the ovule through which the upward movement of the water and minerals take place. And students, this is the two-layered structure that is called integument. The integument are attached on a structure that is called funicel. And from which the spout like this structure funicel is connected with the integument layer. This is called hilum. This is the hilum region, and this is the micropyle. Micropyle is the region through which the insertion of pollen tube is entered inside the ovules for the process of fertilization. This is the challenger. This is the outermost covering part of the ovules, and it helps in attaching the ovules inside the ovarian walls. and this is the vascular strand. Or you can say that vascular bundle, through which the distribution of and transportation of water and minerals take place inside the mucus. Vascular tissue. And in between the integument and the challenger structure, there is the parenchymatous cells are present that forms the endosperm layer of the ovule, that is called mucellus. Mucellus is the parenchymatous cells that containing more nutritive substance which are helpful in the formation of endosperm layer of the ovule. Now students, once again I am going to describe these structures of ovule. This is the structure of an ovule. Students, this is the fumicel. Fumicel is a star-like structure that just lies upon the thalamus part of the flower, and it is the part of the female gamete or gametophyte that helps in attaching the ovules through the ovarian wall. And it is surrounded by a thick ground tissue layer that is called chalaza, and the fumicel having two layers of integument tissues. These integument tissues are attaching with the fumicel at the region that is called thigh. And in inverted direction, there is a minute pore or micropore is present, through which the pollen tube enters inside the ovules for the process of fertilization, that is called micropyle. Students, in between the integument and the chalaza, there is a presence of the parenchymatous cells that forming the endosperm layer of the ovule. This is called mucellus. Mucellus contain the nutritious storage of substances that helps in the development of the ovules and further the process of fertilization. It on maturity forming the endosperm layer. And the endosperm layer, after the complete process of fertilization, get forming the epicorplate of the fruit. Now students, our ovule is a 7-celled structure. These are the 3 cells that are called uppermost, topmost cells, that are called synergized cells. They are the haploid cells, and remaining 3 basal cells are the antipodal cells. They are also haploid cells. And a central secondary nucleus cells is present, having 2 haploid sets of chromosomes. Thus students, when the pollen tube enters through the micropyle, it first attaching a antipodal cell, or you can say that fuse with the antipodal cell, that is also called X cell. And during that time, the another male gamete that is secreted by the pollen tube, it means from the pollen tube at a time 2 male gametes are secreted. The second male gametes are secreted that fertilize the secondary nucleus. Thus, the nucleus containing three haploid sets of chromosomes, this is called triple fusion. Yes, students, this is called triple fusion. And the triple fusion and the fusion of egg antipodal cell and the male gamete is take place simultaneously and one after one. Such type of fertilization is known as double fertilization. Yes, student, this is called double fertilization. Let's here I am going to describe what kind of structures are formed during the this process when a male gamete is transferred to the female gamete. It means how the anther, how the pollen grains from the anther is transferred to the stigma of the flower, and what kind of changes take place during such a time. This is a overview. The antipodal cells, the synergid cells, and the nucleus, secondary nucleus, or nucleus. Here I am taking some pollen grains which goes on the process of germination. It means the formation of pollen tube take place. Students, either the transferred pollen grains, each and every pollen grains start germination, but the first pollen grains that germinate to enters inside the micropyle first fertilize, and then another germinating pollen grains become recessive. Yes, students, the first pollen tube that will come in contact and penetrating the micropyle to enter for the fusion with the ovules become accessible, and the remaining pollen grains become degenerate during that time. Two gamete cells are secreted by this pollen tube. The first fused with the egg cell, the synergid from the antipodal cell, and the second male gamete fuses with the secondary nucleus. Secondary nucleus. Thus, the fusion of the male gamete with the egg cell, this is called fertilization, and the another male gamete fuses with the secondary nucleus to form a triple haploid sets of gametes are a zygote having three haploid sets of chromosomes. This is called triple fusion. And the fusion and the triple fusion collectively called the double fertilization. Thus, students, the process of fertilization in plants take place. Students, the transfer of the pollen grains from the anther to stigma of the flower, this is called pollination. Yes, students, pollination is the process in which the transfer of the pollen grains from anther to stigma of the flower, this is called pollination. Pollination is of mainly two types, the self pollination and cross pollination. If you are going to discuss about the self-pollination, then self-pollination is the process in which the pollen grains from the anther is transferred on the same flower stigma. It means the pollen grains of the same flower is when transferred on the same stigma of the flower, such type of pollination is known as self-pollination. Whereas when the pollen grains of a flower is transferred to the nearby stigma of the flower, such type of pollination is known as cross-pollination. There are three main factors which are responsible for the process of cross-pollination. First one is insects. Yes, students, when insects attracting on the petals, colorful petals of the flower, during that time pollen grains are attached on their surfaces or bodies or in appendages, and when they sit on the another flower's stigma for sucking the nectar, then the pollen grains of the flower is transferred on the stigma. This is the cross pollination with the help of insect. Likewise, when the winds blow, then the pollen grains of the flower is transferred to the neighboring stigma of the flowers. This is known as the pollination, cross pollination by wind. And the water is also responsible at a great extent for the process of cross pollination, because when this is very common in the plants like coconut, yes students, and aquatic plants. In aquatic plants, the male gamete diffuses its gametes, that is with the help of water, it means by floating, they get fused with the female gamete of the another flower. Thus the insects, the wind and the water, as well as some animals, are also responsible for the process of cross pollination. Thus students, after the fertilization, what is fertilization? You all of you very well know that the fusion of male and female gamete is known as fertilization. After fertilization, the ovules get converted into seeds and the ovary get converted into the fruits, and the endocarp of the ovules get converted as epicarp. Endosperm of the fruit is turns into the epicarp. Thus this is called the peel of the fruit. This kind of changes take place in a flower, and this builds the formation of a fruit from a flowering plant. Thanks students for joining today's lecture. And one thing more important, we will in next video lecture study about the sexual reproduction in higher animals as well as the reproduction in human beings. Thanks students.